Uy, sino siya? Ang lakas ng dating, ang lakas ng dating, ang lakas ng
Hi guys, I want to talk to you guys about Stormy Daniels and Karen McDougal, I think is her name. First of all these women coming out and saying that they slept with Donald Trump, this is just getting, it just has a three-ring circus appeal. I really don't give a fuck about him fucking Stormy Daniels or Karen McDougal. Or I can't remember that woman's name. They seem to want to put Stormy Daniels out there, but the Karen lady is kind of like in the background, and she's just like trying her best to be seen and to be noticed. That's what it looks like to me. But anyway, Karen McDougal, I believe every word that she said, and I also believe everything that Stormy Daniels says. I believe that they're really they really did sleep with Donald Trump. And unfortunately, you know, they want to get money, I guess. I know Stormy Daniels is after money. She's after money, and she's trying to be a kept lady. She's trying to be, you know, she's trying hard to be out there in the media spotlight. She's trying hard to be seen as this beautiful woman who slept with the president. I know she claims that she tried to come out with her story before that, but they, you know, she got threatened and she got all this other stuff that she claims happened to her. Okay, so, oh, my arm is getting tired holding this camera. Okay, so, Stormy Daniels, girl, why would you wait until this time to come out with it? I truly don't believe that this is going to hurt Donald Trump. And to be honest with you, he didn't even answer to any of it. He didn't answer to a freaking word of it. And I wouldn't either. It's just so ridiculous. It's a three-ring circus. And to be honest with you, I still support Donald Trump. I voted for Trump. I'm a Trumper. And the reason why I like Donald Trump, I'm going to tell you right now, is that he's a strong businessman. He's a very strong businessman. He got a good head on his shoulders. I know he runs off at the mouth sometimes, and he makes mistakes when he talks. But I honestly really trust Donald Trump, and I think that he's going to do great things with this country if people can just stop it with the three-ring circus media attention. You know, I've never seen any, when you think about Donald Trump compared to Obama. Now, when Obama was the president, all we saw and all we heard was good things, constant good things. All it was that, you know, Obama, he's so great. He's so great. Oh, Obama, he's so fantastic. There was some little stuff about his birth certificate, but for the most part, everybody was behind Obama. I mean, it was like he could do no wrong. You didn't see any scandals about Obama. But then when Trump is the president, it's like, it's all kinds of scandals. It is all kinds of scandals. It's ridiculous. So, I don't give a fuck about Stormy Daniels. I think she's gonna have her time, her 15 minutes of fame, and then she's gonna go, you know, where she belongs, wherever she lives, and she's just gonna live a quiet life. Maybe she'll get some money, maybe she won't, who knows. But Karen, the ex-Playboy bunny, I know she's not gonna get any money. She's upset because she didn't get money. You got to watch all the interviews. I watched both of the Anderson Cooper interviews with Stormy Daniels on 60 Minutes and Karen McDougal on CNN. I watched all of them. So anyway, I don't care about Stormy Daniels. I wish her the best, and I don't care about Karen McDougal. I'm still a Trumper. I still believe in Donald Trump. I still wish him the best. So that's all for now. Bye.
For sitting here talking to me today, you could be fined $1 million. I mean, aren't you taking a big risk?
I am.
I guess I'm not 100% sure on why you're doing this.
Because it was very important to me to be able to defend myself. I was in a parking lot going to a fitness class with my infant daughter. I was taking, you know, the seats facing backwards in the back seat, diaper bag, you know, getting all the stuff out. And a guy walked up on me and said to me, "Leave Trump alone, forget the story." And then he leaned around and looked at my daughter and said, "A beautiful little girl, it'd be a shame if something happened to her mom." And then he was gone.
Did you go to the police?
No.
Why?
Because I was scared. I believe without a shadow of a doubt in my heart, and some people argue that I don't have one of those, but whatever, that I was doing the right thing. I turned down a large payday multiple times because one, I didn't want to kiss and tell and be labeled all the things that I'm being labeled now. I didn't want to take away from the legitimate and legal, I'd like to point out, career that I've worked very hard to establish. And most importantly, I did not want my family and my child exposed to all the things that she's being exposed to right now. Because everything that I was afraid of coming out has come out anyway. And guess what? I don't have $1 million.
So you signed and released a statement that said, I'm not denying this affair because I was paid in hush money. I'm denying it because it never happened. That's a lie.
Yes.
If it was untruthful, why did you sign it?
Because they made it sound like I had no choice.
I mean, no one was putting a gun to your head.
Not physical violence, no.
You thought that there would be some sort of legal repercussion if you didn't sign
Correct.
It.
Correct. As a matter of fact, the exact sentence used was, they can make your life hell in many different ways.
They being?
I'm not exactly sure who they were. I believe it to be Michael Cohen.
The president watches 60 Minutes. If he's watching tonight, what would you say to him?
He knows I'm telling the truth.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I wouldn't want it done to me. I'm sorry. You know, he said hello like he would to anybody. And then throughout the night, it was kind of obvious that there was an attraction from his part to me. Our first date, I was told we were going to go to the Beverly Hills Hotel for dinner. After we had been intimate, he tried to pay me. And I actually didn't know how to take that.
Did he actually try to hand you money?
He did. I can tell you we saw each other a minimum 5 times a month. Up to bigger numbers per month. So we
over the course of how long?
Over the course of 2006 through I think I ended the relationship April 2007. So we were together 10 months before I chose to end it. There was a real relationship there. There were real feelings between the two of us, not just myself, not just him. There was a real relationship there. I couldn't wait to get out of the apartment, actually. I think doing something wrong is bad enough, but when you're doing something wrong and you're in the middle of somebody else's home or bed or whatever, that just puts a little stab in your heart. And honestly, if you can tell, I tried to keep my distance. I tried to go as far away as I could. Just because I felt guilty. I just needed to get out of it. I just needed to get out of it. It just was tearing me apart.
If Melania Trump is watching this, what would you want her to know?
What can you say except, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.